DJ non finisce mai.
La roba che fa ridere è che andiamo a vedere il cricket, che cricket in inglese cosa vuol dire anche
lì. Dicelo figlio, lo sposo farò io, la formi tutta, sono contenta anch'io.
No, che scusa, che c'è?
Nella vecchia fattoria, ia ia o, dove c'è proprio utopia, ia ia o.
Vabbè, niente.
Vedrai che cambierà.
Sunshine came softly through my window today. Could have slipped out to see you, but I've changed my ways. It'll take time, I know it, but in a while you're gonna be mine, I know it. We're doing it in style, cause I made my mind up. You're going to be mine, I'll tell you right now. Out on a rainbow that you can have all your own. When you've made your mind up forever to be mine, I'll pick up your hand slowly.
Ibrox is an area more than...
Ibrox is an area.
Ibrox.
Ibrox.
The rough area, just like the East End, or...
It's not as bad as the East End, no.
Right.
In fact, I live about half an hour's walk from here, just slightly further
really?
South.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So if the nearest underground train station to me would be Ibrox.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. Is this the last stop on the tube?
Well, it's a circle, so it just goes round and round.
Yeah, right.
There's Patsy Cross and says, don't kill heat that never sleeps. George's Cross and Govan Cross, where all the people meet. Wesley Shields drove the train, goes round and round. You never listen unless you've been on the Glasgow Underground.
Is it around all night? No.
No, it finishes at about 11:30, 12-ish.
All right.
But on a Sunday it finishes at about 6.
In the morning?
No, in the evening.
In the evening?
Yeah.
Oh.
There's no way to get home on the underground on a Sunday night. I think the council wants us all to go to bed early on a Sunday, so we're up for work on a Monday morning. But it doesn't happen.
Yeah. But was this originally the more Protestant area? It's nothing to do with...
I assume it was, but I'm actually not certain.
Yeah.
Might have to ask Sandy. It's actually quite mixed up in the city now, like between Catholic and Protestant.
Right.
But originally there were areas which were more Catholic or more Protestant.
Right.
But I imagine...
Like it is in Belfast, I guess, right?
Yeah, well, it's still much more divided in Belfast.
In Belfast,
yeah. And in Derry or Londonderry.
Oh, stadium.
So here's Ibrox.
Quindi fanno il welcome drink?
Un welcome drink, un tramezzo... Madonna! La Madonna! Porco Giuda!
Porca troia! Minchia lo taglio!
How many games for Rangers? Like hundreds of games?
Oh, I played 778.
Whoa! Has anybody played more?
Yeah, two other players.
Really?
Aye.
Huh.
Sick then, eh?
Oh, wow.
Well,
how many seasons is that?
I came here in 1964, and I left in 1982.
So you really started with
18 years.
Youth team? I mean, of...
Yeah, yeah. But that was only first team games. I didn't get in the first team until I was 18.
Well, so still pretty
still good. I'm proud of it.
And play with Scotland as well.
Aye.
So,
Rangers are going through a very peculiar phase, right? I mean,
aye, basically,
what's happening technically?
Well, what happened is the club got sold last year to a new owner.
Yeah.
And basically he mismanaged the club on a grand scale.
The new owner?
Yeah, Craig White. And basically ran the club into the ground. Didn't pay bills, they ran up huge debts.
Wow.
And because of that, the club got put into administration.
Huh.
So now the club has come through our administration. He has left.
Yeah.
What we have to do is try and rebuild the club again.
Right.
So we're...
Well, you stayed.
Aye. And the big thing is, not just me that stayed. The most important thing is we've got... Every game is 50,000 sellout, so the 50,000 people have stayed.
Right, right.
We think we've been treated rather harshly by our football associations.
Yeah.
So we start in the third division, and we have to work up like Fiorentina did.
I heard that when, you know, the supporters heard about this, you know, they sort of managed to, or they tried to raise.
Oh yeah, funds. But I'm on the fighting fund committee, and what we wanted to do is to ensure our club survived.
Right.
So they donated money, I think about £600,000, and that was the money was spent on the pitch.
All right.
To keep the pitch going.
Yeah.
So we ensured that the club was still running.
Yeah.
And then the new owner came in. And he now takes over that.
Is he going to talk it in, Brian? I'd be very surprised if this isn't a booking. Totally missed time there from Kyle Bartley. Well, Scott Brown can smile. He's lucky he managed to get his feet off the ground. Oh, he turned into a lot of traffic here, Scott Brown. Well, I'm not surprised it's a yellow card.
No, we have a derby.
You have a derby?
Yeah. Before Celtic were formed in 1888. Right?
Yeah.
We were formed in 1872.
So, you, okay.
There is a team in Glasgow, Queen's Park.
Yeah.
We were formed in, I think it was 1869. So
even before?
Yeah. So the very first derby Rangers had was with Queen's Park, although they are a very small club now.
Right.
So we were...
They're in third division.
Yeah. So we will now have a derby, the oldest derby in Scotland.
Wow,
in
okay, yeah. Okay.
So it's a nice way to go over it.
Yeah. But at one point, didn't you, I know you played the World Cup in 74 in Germany, right?
Yeah.
And that you were defender, and you sort of like shared the defensive line with a Celtic player, right?
Aye, Danny McGinn. Danny.
Yeah. How was that, like, for the fans and for you guys, like, because you were like enemies.
No.
I mean, at the derby, you played versus each other.
When we play against each other, yeah.
Yeah.
But he was a very nice person.
All right.
It was just like when you go in Italy, when
AC
Milan players go with Inter Milan players, the national team.
Yeah.
Everybody wants to play with your national team. And when you do there, you become a professional. And,
right.
And although the supporters might hate, not the right word, they're very, you know, don't like each other.
Yeah. But when it's the players, national team.
Players are players. And they're for the grace of God go I. Because what could happen to me could happen to him.
Right.
And as I say, he was a great player and a very nice lad.
Right.
And I'm still friendly with him now.
Really?
Yeah.
Sempre di corsa il regista.
Se dormi col jeans vengono i 7 giorni di capitani.
Non spermira tutto perché devi fare il pilates in camera, no?
Oh, sono freddo, sono di Foggia, ragazzi, cioè, per me non è...
No, io il champagne niente.
sempre problemi e soldi non ho mai avuto.
Come diceva il tuo amico.
Come diceva mio amico.
Diamo letti nel pensiero.
Sei un billing.
But by the way, what do you think about haggis burger?
It was nice, actually, yeah.
Was it?
Uh-huh, yeah.
But the haggis...
I think you should try it before you go.
I can't do that, you know, like... But you said that the haggis is sort of like a big dish. In the burger, it was just
a tiny little pat. Yeah.
So that wouldn't dissolve or explode.
No, but you see, that will have come out of a larger haggis, you see.
Oh.
So a traditional haggis would be a whole sheep's stomach packed with bits of meat and offal and oats.
Right,
you
blood.
Don't look like you'd enjoy it. I think they put some blood in, but they usually mainly use blood for black pudding.
Right.
Which is different.
Chef Alanto.
We also play France.
That's a wonderful name. What do you mean?
It's like, you know, when you have a
high
body, you can put a shuffle. Yeah. Do you want
another one? Chef Alanto. Wonderful.
I think Glasgow is a very unique situation, you know,
because it's still separate, you mean?
Glasgow, dear old Glasgow town, but what's the matter with Glasgow for? It's going round and round. I'm only a common old working chap, as anyone can see. But when I get a couple of drinks on a Saturday, Glasgow belongs to me.
I think yeah. One team, you tell me, but, you know.
Tell us, the war is very different, no?
Yeah, I mean, broadly speaking, if you went to a Catholic school, they would grow up supporting Celtic, and if you went to a non-denominational school, you'd grow up supporting Rangers, broadly speaking.
But it's still like that.
Yeah, although you definitely have, I mean, we've got friends that are Protestant that support Celtic, but I don't think you'd be hard-pushed to find many Catholics that would support Rangers, I think.
Right. Okay.
And the clubs were like that as well in terms of, Celtic always played Protestants, whereas Rangers were exclusive, weren't they, for a while?
I see. So, would that mean that even the players would fall into that category?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean, even up until recent times, Basil Bowley.
We're talking about 1988 before they signed.
Before.
Mojo.
I mean, even look at Basil Bowler when he came on and blessed himself.
Yeah.
That kind of thing.
Up until very recently. Up until the late 80s, he didn't play Catholic.
Like in the Basque Country, like all the players from Athletic Bilbao, they would be
fun. Yeah, kind of like that.
Was there ever a player that played for both teams, for example?
A couple. Yeah.
Well, they went from Celtic to Rangers the other way around.
They never went directly. There was Alfie Conn was one. The most famous one was Mojo.
Mojo.
Morris Johnson.
Mojo.
Morris
yeah.
Johnson.
Who had played for Celtic. He was a Celtic hero.
He was a Celtic hero.
Yeah. And off they played in France for a while. And he came back and said he was going to sign for Celtic. He put a Celtic jersey on. He'd got... done the press conference, said he was going to sign.
Yeah.
And then he came and signed for Rangers.
Yeah.
After that, so it was like uproar in the city. Judah, 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 Judah.
DJ, non finisce mai.
Diciamo che con gli anni il metodo per far andare il jukebox non è cambiato, anche col jukebox digitale. Un pugno alla terra. pugno pulito.
Remember this player called Enrico Annone?
Yeah? Uh-huh. Yes? Like Enrico.
Did he live a good, did he left on good terms?
Oh, very,
very,
very, very, very,
very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very,
very, very,
very, very, very, very, very,
very, very,
very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very, very,
very, very,
Rico.
We used to call him Tarzan,
you
know?
Yeah.
Well, Tarzan, Tarzan Annoli,
It's a shame. It was, to be honest, it was getting to the stage that was what you paid your season ticket for, was four games a season.
Mm. I'm not going to miss it.
Panthers are bringing back the, they're bringing back the cup.
I was talking about making this old cup, the Glasgow Cup.
The Glasgow Cup?
But they've only got
the Glasgow Cup will basically be the Celtic versus the Rangers, right?
Well,
that's
what
the Scottish Cup.
The Scottish Cup.
Is there such a thing?
Yeah.
Scottish Cup, right.
Yeah. I mean, we don't know if they're going to be able to field a team next season. They've only got about six or seven players at the moment. So
far? Yeah. Everybody left?
A lot of people decided their contract
was doing this. Come on, it was good news for you guys.
I don't know. I prefer European games. There's a lot of hatred comes out in the derby. That,
really? Yeah.
Two really big scores in sort of late 90s, early 2000s. We beat them 5-1 one year and 6-2 another year, and they were both just...
I like the 6-2 game. That was amazing. Chris Sutton scored the fastest goal for him goal in history.
And he was offside.
And he was... I'm being mild.
So it made it even better. The 5-1 game for me was amazing because that was my first game, not a season ticket, first goal for me I've seen, and it was... We weren't expected to win.
What's the difference between heel and heel?
Heel.
Oh, heel.
Heel and hill.
Hill.
Yeah.
And garlic?
No, Gaelic?
How do you say that?
Gaelic.
But what about garlic?
Garlic.
Say it again?
Gaelic.
Yeah.
Which is a language. And garlic. But in Irish, Gaelic would be called Gaelic. The English version of the Irish word would be Gaelic. Whereas the Scottish would be Gaelic.
Oh, I see. Okay. No rain. Where else would you wear a kilt, you know, for like a ceremony, for example?
Yeah, things like graduations, weddings, funerals, I suppose. Birthday parties, sort of stag parties and that kind
stag
of thing. Just any kind of... We pretty much... You can justify it for anything, more or less. I can even justify it for my work, but... I don't
Right. Well, you don't need to wear a kilt in the store, right? Or
sometimes people do. Andy, one of the other managers, has got a full tartan suit with a top hat as well.
Wow.
So it doesn't always have to be a kilt, just tartan, you know?
Wonder if it's true what they don't wear beneath the kilt.
And that's the Scottish kilt, right? Because, for example, in Ireland, they would have just one collar.
In Ireland now, they have a few tartans as well.
Oh, really?
different sort of areas have got their own regional
right.
tartan. There's a few tartans that we make that are actually Irish surnames and stuff like that as well. It's either a family or a group of families that are historically
right.
close.
Right.
So maybe five or six surnames might be one sort of clan tartan.
Like surnames like...
Well, for example, mine's is Sharp, but it's actually the Stuart of Bute clan.
All
so
right.
there's maybe four other surnames that all would wear that tartan.
All right.
So it's not necessarily just your last name. It could be a
surname.
Right. It's just because there used to be little communities dotted all over the place.
Yeah.
So the close-knit communities might have just one tartan for a couple of them. And then
right.
in a different area, they might have a sort of more.
Excuse me? Are you wearing a skirt?
What are you, that sissy girl? This is no skirt. This be a utility kilt made from the finest duck cloth. Ah, so soft. Fashioned from the traditional garb of the Celtic warriors.
And this goes way back to the 1600s, or is that the era?
I think that's when that's the earliest they've found kilts from.
Right.
So it could be longer.
Right.
I mean, these kilts here are made like just as a sort of waist down thing.
Right.
Historically, it would just be one big bit of cloth wrapped right the way around. So like in Braveheart and stuff like that, you know, the one big bit
yeah,
of cloth
yeah.
over the shoulder, around the waist.
Right.
And it was just one big length of cloth.
Right.
Now these are made more formal, you know, you wear a jacket with it, shirt, maybe a tie or a bow tie, and it's,
right.
it's the equivalent of a trouser, sort of.
Well, that's a big stereotype with the kilt, but you tell me if it's not a stereotype. You know, most people tell us that you're not
yeah.
supposed undies to wear undies
oh, no.
under the kilt.
Definitely not.
Why is that?
Well, I guess
it sounds cold, you know, just because of the...
Sometimes, yeah, sometimes it is. But on a hot day, it's good.
Right.
The wind gets it.
Right, what's the wind? Yeah, and the wind, too.
Yeah.
The wind is there, too.
Absolutely, yeah.
yeah.
Well, I mean, I've worn a kilt in Italy before. And
in LA?
In Italy.
In Italy?
Yeah, Marina di Carrara.
Right,
beer festival that happens every year, so I definitely wouldn't wear underwear for that, no.
Right, but in the winter, come on, sometimes do people...
Some people do, yeah,
some people
it's a personal
do.
Choice, I guess.
Right.
But the majority of people, I think, don't.
Right, because that would be kind of like not...
That's
right.
part of the history and the tradition of it, yeah, so...
Right.
There's a bit of fun with it as well. It's a wee cheeky thing, you never know, you never
right.
quite know
right.
what's happening under there, so...
Siamo da Jeffrey, il miglior negozio di kilt di Glasgow in Scozia e DJ Aladdin proverà per voi i 5 migliori kilt. Cominciamo dalla posizione numero 5, occupata da un grigio contemporaneo.
Grigio, noia mortale.
Cioè, praticamente vi stiamo mandando in tilt, anzi che dico, ci stiamo mandando in kilt. Posizione numero 4, un altro kilt tradizionale ma moderno contemporaneamente, questo è il Claret Thistle.
Ragazzi di oggi noi.
Come ci spiegava Cammi, spesso e volentieri il classico tessuto scozzese, a seconda del colore, appartiene a una o più famiglie tipiche appunto del nord dell'isola sulla quale siamo in questo momento a stare, che gli antenati dei di Chiano, i Mac di Chiano, vestissero proprio con questo tessuto, cioè il Black Watch.
All'interno trovi del pomodorino secco.
Mentre l'intera comunità di sciaffolato si starà chiedendo, ma Albino di Chiano e altri di Gerardi, alla fine queste mutande sotto il kilt, le sta mettendo, non le sta mettendo? Lo vediamo che gli prude, che cosa ci metti là dentro?
Qui dentro ci metto i ticket da 6,20 € per andare a pranzo, anche se qui non li accetto. Questo è molto grunge come moderno.
Molto piace, infatti, posizione numero 2, Modern Rat Fraser. When I'm with you, it's paradise. E finalmente è arrivato il momento della numero uno, della cosiddetta number one dei migliori kilt che abbiamo incontrato da Jeffrey a Glasgow. Mi sembra di capire anche qualcosa di più che un kilt. Il kilt è il purple thistle, ma è un deep purple. Oh, e poi voi state ancora pensando, oh no, ci sono i bambini! Ma bagnato poi? Fatto la pipì?
Oh madonna! Quindi con fai quando la volte? No, lui va tutto. Lui forse è con tutto l'odio, ma è una porta la peggio.
Stavo dicendo
sì. Perché Stilacci era emo.
Eh beh, sì,
cioè,
vero.
Era.
Comunque ci sono
andato. Quell'emo, quell'emo che però dici, ma no, ma tu no, cazzo. Cioè.
Con quei tre.
Era proprio te, cazzo. Perché, cazzo? Totò, dai!